Welcome to the first video in the Acontis EC Simulator tutorial video series. Over the course of these videos, we will cover a variety of topics to help you get started and use all of the features of EC Simulator. For a quick introduction to the EC Simulator software, be sure to check out our product introduction video. In this first tutorial video, we will walk you through creating a simulator configuration, installing the software, and demonstrating the example application to simulate slave devices. For this tutorial, we will use a computer running EC Engineer connected to real slaves to create the simulator configuration file. EC Simulator uses the ENI file to describe the devices in the network, so we will start with creating the ENI file using EC Engineer. It is possible to use another software application to create the ENI file or even an existing ENI file from a previous configuration. Start EC Engineer and select Online Configuration. For help and instructions on using EC Engineer, be sure to check out our EC Engineer tutorial video series. Be sure to select the correct link layer driver and network adapter that is connected to the real slaves. EC Engineer will scan the network and you can see the devices that are discovered in the Project Explorer area. Our setup consists of a Beckhoff coupler and some digital outputs and digital inputs. From here, you can make further configuration changes or simply decide to use the defaults as we will do. Click the Export ENI button to export the ENI file and save it. With the ENI file created from EC Engineer, EC Simulator can simulate the actual slave devices configured previously. So now we will disconnect the real slaves from EC Engineer and connect a computer that we will install EC Simulator on and start the example application. Note that we have stored the ENI file in a folder on the desktop. Now we will change over to the simulator system. EC Simulator is available for a wide variety of operating systems and CPU architectures. For this tutorial video, we will demonstrate EC Simulator running on Windows on x86 PC architecture. Run the EC Simulator installer and go through the installation prompts. On Windows, the installer checks to ensure an appropriate link layer driver for the network adapter is available. If no driver is installed, the installer prompts you to launch the Acontis ECAP protocol driver after the installation, and also provides links to download alternative drivers. After EC Simulator is installed, click through the ECAP protocol driver installation prompts to complete the installation. For the EC Simulator example application in Windows, we will need the IP address of the network adapter. Open a command prompt to start the simulator example application. The IP address must be set manually, so make sure to assign an IP address to the appropriate network adapter. You can check the IP address here as well with the ipconfig command. By default, the example application is installed in program files in the Acontis Technologies directory in the bin Windows x64 folder. The example application uses various command line arguments and options to specify how to execute the application. A complete list of command line arguments and options is included in our online documentation, which is linked below in the description. For our setup, we will use the NDIS ECAP protocol driver we installed previously. We will further specify the ENI file to use, to flash the outputs on slave device 1004, and to run indefinitely. The example application starts up and prints some information to the terminal window. At this point, the slave devices are being simulated on the network. We will now switch back again to the other PC system and use EC Engineer, acting as the EtherCAT master, to operate the network of simulated slaves. We are still connected to the same network adapter with the same configuration, so we will simply start the embedded master included in EC Engineer by clicking the Diagnosis Mode button. When switching to Diagnosis Mode in EC Engineer, we are prompted if we would like to set the state to operational. We will do so, and you can see in the command terminal on the simulator system that the slave devices transitioned to the operational state. We can further use EC Engineer to check the digital outputs that the simulator is flashing on the slave with station address 1004. Click the Variables tab when slave 1004 is selected, and you can see the digital output values changing in the chart area. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below, or you can contact us on our website. Thanks for watching, and hopefully this video helps you get started with simulating EtherCAT networks and devices using EC Simulator. As you have seen, the process is easy and fast to get a simulated system up and running for your development and testing. In future videos, we will demonstrate different use cases for how you can take advantage of EC Simulator, along with how to use more advanced features. So please subscribe to our channel to be sure not to miss these future videos, as well as additional tutorial videos for our other products.